What is Wheatstone bridge? It is an electric circuit or electric network which consists of four resistive elements, and the fifth resistive element forms a bridge arm. What exactly I mean to say with resistive element? Elements मतलब ऐसी कोई भी चीज जो कि करंट फ्लो करने में ऑब्स्ट्रक्ट कर रही है, वो से रेजिस्टेंस ऑफर करती है. इफ यू लुक बैक, देर आर मेनली थ्री एलिमेंट्स विच आर ऑफरिंग रेजिस्टेंस टू द फ्लो ऑफ करंट इन डिफरेंट मैनर्स. एक तो है रेजिस्टर, दूसरा है कैपेसिटर, तीसरा है इंडक्टर. Apart from these elements, there is no device available in this world which is free from resistance. It offers some or other internal resistance, including galvanometer and voltmeter, which you are using in your lab. So, what is Wheatstone bridge? It's a it is an electric circuit or network which consists of five resistance offering elements, and fifth one makes a bridge arm. So four are here, but here for your class there are resistances, capacitances also you can replace, no problem. So there are four resistances placed here, P, Q, R, S, and fifth resistance is resistance offered by galvanometer, G. And there is a cell or battery across these two terminals, A, B, C, D. Fine. So we are going to derive an expression. Say I say total current is I. I1 goes this way. I2 after division goes this way. Still you have to follow Kirchhoff's loop. At B, Ig goes through galvanometer. Then here you can write I1 minus Ig, or you can choose I3, no problem. Ig is approaching at this junction, I2 is approaching from A. Now at junction D there are only three paths, so two are already occupied through which current is approaching to the D. So this will be an outlet and current will be equal to I plus Ig. Now I2 plus Ig approaches from here at C, I1 minus Ig approaches here. So finally you are left with I. That's how you are able to do it. Right? Now, for balanced Wheatstone bridge, Ig should be zero. That is, current through galvanometer is zero. If it is zero, it means this implies potential difference across point B and D is zero. This also implies potential of point B is equal to potential of point D. So these are the conditions for balanced Wheatstone bridge. Let's see what relation comes out between four other resistors in the Wheatstone bridge. So using Kirchhoff's law, in loop A B D A, पहले इसमें लगाते हैं I1 into P, plus ig into g minus i2 into r equals to 0, because there is no EMF source in the loop. दूसरा लूप चूज करो, इन लूप बी सी डी बी आई वन माइनस आई जी इंटू क्यू माइनस आई टू प्लस आई जी इंटू एस माइनस आई जी इंटू जी इज इक्वल टू 0 अगेन. So you have obtained two equations after applying Kirchhoff's rules. Now use condition Ig is equal to 0. When you put Ig equals to 0, this term will be absent. This term will not be there. This term will not be there. This term will also be gone. So we are left with putting balance beat bridge conditions Ig equals to 0. So you will have I1P is equal to I2R and I1Q will be equal to I2S dividing 3 by 4 you will get P over Q is equal to R over S. That's how it works it out very well. So when Wheatstone bridge is balanced, the ratio of the resistances, value of resistances in the corresponding arms is always same. The reverse of this is also true. If you see any electrical network which carries 5 resistors and out of 5 resistors this relation holds good, that is the ratio of any two resistance is equal to the ratio of any other two resistors, then it means the fifth resistance placed in the circuit has no significance, because through this there is no current is flowing, there is no potential difference across this resistor, so fifth resistance will not have any significance. So reverse is also true for this, right? But if Wheatstone bridge is not balanced, then what? When Wheatstone bridge is not balanced, then no option is except to go on Kirchhoff's law and solve the problems by forming equations. Let's see last year board question, it was very interesting. One more thing you should remember, by changing the terminals of EMF source and galvanometer, it hardly matters. It hardly matters means galvanometer is connected right now in between B and D. Battery is connected in between A and C. So what I do, if I change this AC, battery from AC and connected across BD, and galvanometer we connect across A and C, will it make any difference? Will this ratio be still okay, work? Answer is yes, it does not matter. So similarly, there was a question based on it last year in a board examination. So he drawn two Wheatstone bridge circuit, number one like this, and since already drawn, so I am using this circuit. One is like this. Question one. And the values given are in figure 1 are 4, R1 and 6 ohm, 9 ohm Another circuit is reversed, that is, I can draw this circuit here. This resistance is given 6 ohm. This was given as 12 ohm. This is given as R2. This is given as 8 ohm. And battery is connected here. Galvanometer is connected here. And it was declared that these two bridges are balanced. If figure 1 and figure 2, figure 1, figure 2 shows balanced Wheatstone bridge, then find R1 over R2 ratio. Where is R1 here? If it is balanced Wheatstone bridge, means 4 over R1 is equal to 6 by 9. So R1 is equal to 9 by 6 into 4. How much it is? 6. Similarly, from here, figure 2, 6 by 12 is equal to R2 by 8. So R2 is equal to 6 by 12 into 8, that is 4 ohm. Therefore, R1 over R2 is equal to 6 by 4, 3 is to 2. Easy question, that you can always do it without any problem. Let's see now some other questions to find equivalent resistance, and these questions are based on Wheatstone bridge. I advise, whenever equivalent question is asked in the question or given in the question paper which is containing or carrying 5 resistors, first make sure whether this is Wheatstone bridge circuit or not. See question number 2. Is this is a triangle I can make. Now each arm of this triangle is having resistance. R, 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 and question is find equivalent resistance between A and B. Let's see, pick up these two points A and B and open like up. When you open like envelope, this point will come out somewhere here, point A. Resistance R will go point A, and resistance R will go this way, this resistance, and this resistance will go somewhere here. In between, this resistance will come, this resistance will remain there, this resistance also is there, and since B is turned towards right, so B will be here. Isn't it Wheatstone bridge? Now since ratios are same, so this resistance has no significance. No significance means R and R in series. So R dash is equal to 2R upper R. I am talking about these two. Similarly, lower arm, R double dash is equal to 2R. Now this upper arm and lower arm are parallel. So R equivalent, 1 over R equivalent is equal to 1 over R dash, R double dash, that is 1 over 2R plus 1 over 2R, R equivalent is equal to R. Let's see one more question. And this question almost appears clearly if you can identify that it is a Wheatstone bridge. R, 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 point A. Point B. Now this is bridge R. So same situation, R and R in series, R and R in series, R equivalent is equal to R. Let's see another question. Find equivalent resistance for a each resistance is R ohm. Find equivalent resistance between equivalent or net resistance between A and B. Now see, there are two, very significantly there are two Wheatstone bridge balance, number one, number two, and this we have seen. For each equivalent, each Wheatstone bridge, the resistance is how much? Equivalent resistance, upper one is R, lower one is R, by this or that does not matter. And finally you have two resistance, which are two resistances each of value R, are placed in parallel. So used 1 over R equivalent is equal to 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2, 1 over R plus 1 over R. So R equivalent is equal to R by 2. So you just be aware of, here you are having 10 resistances but significantly dividing into two Wheatstone bridges, which are balanced.